We started off thinking we would do a fairly traditional cost-benefit analysis, where the innovative part would be to try to provide some kind of a dollar estimate of the social and environmental costs and benefits. But what we found, of course, is that the people in this part of the world, in the highlands of Guatemala, the indigenous people, are extremely poor. So that one could end up with a figure comparing, on the one hand, the benefits to shareholders from this mine, which have topped $850 million in the last 4 years, against the wipeout of the entire community. All 40-some thousand people in this area could die and the entire place destroyed, and you'd end up with quite a small figure, a dollar figure. And this raises profound ethical questions. So we abandoned the traditional cost-benefit methodology and instead decided we would simply, as best we could, estimate revenue flows, real money, flowing to whom, try to figure out how much was going to shareholders, how much was going to the Guatemalan central government, how much was going locally in a variety of channels, and then on the other hand, try to see what we might say about the long-term environmental risks of the mine and put those two against each other. Perhaps the greatest risks of the mine stem from the hydrogeology. The fact that the mine uses a lot of water, there's concern about whether there will be sufficient water for local people and their agricultural pursuits. We add to these normal risks of mining the fact that we are in a period of climate risk. This mine was constructed without any projections forward of flooding, of hurricanes, of intensity, of the climate models that are being used in Central America and around the world, so that the strength of the tailings pond, for example, the depth and how high it needs to be, was projected on flood data from the past. Data are available now. If you look at Guatemala in the middle there, the change in the number of floods, these are high intensity floods from the past 20 years to the 20 years before that, three times. It doesn't even show up on the tropical storms and hurricanes before. This needs to be factored into any kind of a risk assessment of the mine in Guatemala. Okay, and the final point here is there's no real closure plan for this mine, and this is a point that was made by the assessment of the company's own team, the human rights assessment. They've posted a voluntary surety bond of $1 million. That means something happens, there's default, collapse, they walk away, there's $1 million left to clean up this mine. Recent study just came out from COPAI, the Catholic group there in San Marcos, in English, reclamation costs and estimated costs of the closure of the mine. They say, you better have $49 million on hand. These independent studies have been ignored by Goldcorp in its response. This is the human rights assessment that was undertaken with Goldcorp funding, an independent assessment, but at the bottom, it's just again, the absence of data or documentation suggests the company made claims it could not substantiate in a variety of dimensions, and I think this is problematic, this need for substantiation. You know, when are they, what is true, what is not? And this is from the website of Goldcorp. The left-hand side is, wow, going gangbusters for 2011 and 2012. Expansion of the mine, even though their own assessment said that expansion should be halted until issues are resolved. They have not implemented their own human rights assessment recommendations. Here, of course, they were removed from the Dow Jones Sustainability Index in September. So it's not clear that this perception of improvement in relationships all the way around is being accepted as what's going on. In terms of the earnings that this mine is generating for the company, it's the lowest cost producer of all the mines in the Goldcorp portfolio. It's an extraordinarily cash rich, it's almost a cash cow for
for Gold Corp, and what is being offered both via the revenue flows in royalties, via payroll, and via social investment are really crumbs off the table. And it's a very lavish table indeed.
So it's a Faustian bargain. It's a short-term gain for a long-term potential big loss.